Imagine this. You take one image, like a random doodle or your brand's logo, or even a photo of your cat, and in seconds, it transforms into a sticker, plushie, or whatever artsy style you can dream up. No text prompts, no struggling with AI that just doesn't get it, just pure creativity. That's Google Whisk. Today, we're diving into Google Whisk, a new AI tool that just launched on December 16th. I spent a lot of time playing with it already, and I can't wait to show you how it works and where it's a little bit rough around the edges. So let's go ahead and take a look. Okay, so here's the deal with Whisk. Unlike most AI tools that make you type these overly complicated prompts like generate a mystical forest in the style of Van Gogh, but also cyberpunk, Whisk takes a completely different approach. You upload an image, and it uses that as a base to create new, unique versions in different styles. You can then suggest what you want as the subject, the scene, and the style of the AI-generated image. You can then upload multiple images for each of those three elements. It's like Photoshop meets AI and said, let's keep this simple. You don't need to be a designer, and you definitely don't need to have a master's in AI prompt engineering. Just upload, pick a style, and boom, you have new art. All right, so here's how to get started. First, you'll sign up. You'll need access to Google Labs, where Whisk lives. As of now, Whisk is only available to users in the United States. It's still an experimental tool, and since it just launched, I mostly think they're limiting access to gather feedback and improve the tool before opening it up wider. Next, you'll upload your image. This is the fun part. Drag and drop something. Your logo, a photo, your kid's drawing of a dinosaur, anything goes. Next, you'll pick a style. Whisk gives you preset styles like sticker, plushie, and enamel pin. Hit generate and wait for it. In a few seconds, you'll have variations of your image all styled up and ready to impress or make you laugh. And if you're feeling adventurous, you can even click the dice icon to have Google fill in images for the prompts. Though, full disclosure, these are AI generated too. If you want to add extra details, you can type in a little text to guide the process even further. But again, it's all optional. Half of the fun is seeing what it comes up with. Sometimes the results are ready to sell on mugs or t-shirts, on Redbubble or Etsy. Other times the AI has its own creative vision. Here's where Whisk really stands out to me. Got a product idea? You can easily create a quick prototype by uploading your design and seeing how it looks as a sticker or plushie in seconds. Designers can take a basic logo and remix it into a dozen different styles super fast. And let's not forget, Whisk is a playground. If you just want to turn a photo of your dog into a surreal art piece, go for it. It's definitely not perfect. Sometimes the AI gets a little weird. Like, why does the sticker version of my logo look like it's melting? And while the preset styles are fun, you don't have a ton of control over the finer details. If you're expecting polished, production-ready results, you might be disappointed. But honestly, that's part of the charm. It's more like a creative brainstorm buddy than a polished tool. And it's only going to get better. Is Whisk going to replace your design team? No. Is it going to make you laugh, spark new ideas, and maybe help you nail down your next project? Absolutely. I think of it as a fun little creative spark machine. Remember, Whisk is still experimental. It's using the latest iteration of Google's ImageGen 3 model. And while the images take a few seconds to generate, which can be annoying sometimes, everything I've generated has been fun to iterate on. Plus, it generates a text prompt for every image, so you can keep refining things if you'd like. Okay, now it's your turn. What random image are you uploading to Whisk first? Feel free to share them with us in the No-Code Devs community, which you can join using the link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a like, subscribe for new AI tools, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss whatever tool we explore next. Thanks so much and see you next time.